हेलो गाइस, दिस इज़ बेसिक वीडियो फॉर स्पेरी मरीन एग्डिस, स्पेरी मरीन विजन FT. एज़ यू कैन सी ऑन दिस इज़ द लेआउट ऑफ द स्क्रीन. हियर यू कैन फाइंड द हेडिंग, कोर्स ओवर ग्राउंड, स्पीड थ्रू वाटर, स्पीड ओवर ग्राउंड. योर वेक्टर विल शो हियर, ट्रू वेक्टर. योर AIS मैसेजेस विल बी डिस्प्लेड हियर. योर ओन शिप डेटा कम्स हियर. Once you click on this message box, you can see your own ship data and whatever the AIS messages you are getting. You want to read any AIS message, just click on the message. You can read whatever the information is given. If you don't want to keep the message, you can just simply delete the message. Here is the option for the target display. You can see, you can select display targets, number, name, or if you want both, display past position of the targets, interval 8 minutes. Here you can see the AIS display settings. All the settings of the AIS are mentioned here. From here you can change the routes. If you want to monitor a route, click on monitor route, load route, select the route you want and click OK. If you want to clear a route, just clear a route which is loaded. Like you can see, the route was loaded on my screen, but I have just cleared it out. Now I'll route it again. So now you can see the route has come back. In this you have various features like route ETA. Once you click, you can get an ETA for the specified point you want, waypoint you have selected, whatever waypoint you desire to get, you can get it for the present speed by clicking on SOG, or you can put it on planned speed. Planned speed will be whatever the speed you have planned according to your voyage leg. Or if you want to check manually what ETA you want to keep, you can maintain your speed accordingly. Next is edit route. In edit route, as you all know, we can edit any route which we have opened. Like I select and open a route. I click on the same route which I have on. Now I have the route here for editing. I can edit this route. You can see I can move the waypoint anywhere I like. I can take the waypoint shift. So this way you can do an edit of the route. Or if you would like to see the editor table, the table is here. It shows all your details, lat, long and distances, and the waypoint from which to which you have. Leg type you can select here is rum line. If you like, you can select great circle. Then temporary route, you can select a temporary route, you can create and edit a temporary route, but I've never used this feature. Route status will show you the route which you are on and from which waypoint to which waypoint you are sailing. Like I'm sailing from a waypoint number 8 to waypoint number 9 and my route is selected, my cross track is this much, my distance to go to the next waypoint is this much, target time to go is this much, and ETA for the next leg is this. So in the route status tab you will see all these details. Route display settings displays if you want to keep any critical point, waypoint label, perpendicular to leg or wheel over labels, leg bearings, planned speed, cross track alarm lines, it all shows in that. So this is the normal menu of this. Now from here you can see, as you can see on the display, you can select various charts, official charts, ARCS, world. Now from here you have several options: chart tools, chart settings, chart projections, depth, height, database, legend, manual chart update, chart query, chart danger, this is a shortcut, you can say, a kind of a shortcut for this. Like the main menu for the chart, everything is down below here. You go here, chart, you can see chart tools, chart settings, the same thing is displayed over here. So if you go to chart tools, you can see the summary of the chart updates. It is loading. As you can see, all the updates are here. Application date, issue date, issuing authority will be here. In chart settings, you can select the layers. You have a standard display which will show you various things. You can get your chart boundaries here. Your spot soundings which are visible, if you want to deselect, you can just remove it them. If you want to see the accuracy of any chart, you can just go through chart settings, symbology, and click on accuracy. It will show you the chart accuracy. How is the chart accurate? How it is defined, by which CADZOC it is defined. So for CADZOC, we have here accuracy. Paper charts and all. Okay. Now next is chart projection. We are using Mercator chart projection. Chart depths and heights. This is as per the passage plan. We have selected the safety depth, safety contour, safety height, shallow contour and deep contour. Chart database is all three database here. You can check. Chart legend. Chart legend gives you various details about the chart which you are on presently on, the updates which are done on the chart. It will show you the base chart, update which was issued, when was issued, day with the date. All the dates will come for that base chart. Detailed notes will come if there is something from the chart or from the admiralty, if there is something. Other details will be like navigational purpose. It is a general chart, the scale of the chart. What is the shallow contour on this, deep contour, safety depth, safety contour, format, update number and other things. It will show it here. Manual chart update. Manual chart update, from this you can do various things. Like I selected presently a position fix. You can mark a position fix. So for plotting a position fix, numerous method you can use. One is just click on chip. The position will come. As you can see, the position is here. It is already there and according to the time label. So the position will be there. Now if I want, in this you can even plot a back position, a past position which you have missed. If you just want to do a position fix of the GPS fix of a past position, you can just click on create new object, manually create, click on this, and from chart wherever you like. If I like here, I'll just click here, the position will come here. As you can see, the position is here. So this is the way you can do past positions also. So as I mentioned, you can make past positions. So when you do a past position, don't forget to change the time also, or you will just make a past position from chart and then someone will check, he will find out that the time was not changed. So you have to change the time label also. This time here comes UTC time, no local time. It will all the time it will be UTC time. If you want to delete an update, just click on delete and you can delete the position. Okay, like this. Now in this chart update, there are, you can create layers. Like as you can see, we have the layers, different layers. You can mark anchorages, anchor berth, anchor area, anchorage reported, prohibited, prohibited and cautions. Same in after anchorage, you can mark areas. In these areas, an ocean mark, when you make an ocean mark, now you click OK. You have to display something. Like you see, the ocean shows here. This is like, you can mark something, some various updates if you like. You can mark here with the area and ocean mark. You can mark it with various things. You can mark with area deletion. Not in area deletion, this is for deleting. If you like to delete some area, you have to mark, use this one and show that this area was deleted. Caution, information, navigated, caution, prohibited. So specific, you have to specify which marks you have to select for your specific notice which you want to put. Now as you can see, I've already made this bridge watch level, PPI, MARSEC, comply, MARPOL, NX. So these all can be done from manual chart updates. You have this beacons option, then you have buoys option. You can see all the buoys. Then you have danger points. You have geo shapes. You have lines if you like to make any boundary. You have nav marks. In other points, it will show you the position fix, which I was telling you before. And lastly is soundings, low accuracy sounding, sounding and swift sounding. If you like, you can mark it on the chart. Now let's go to geo shapes. In this ACDIS, in other ACDISes, when you are at anchorage, you can mark a turning circle, and that turning circle, if you are out of the turning circle, it will give an alarm. But in this ACDIS, you don't have a specific turning circle, so you have to maintain your watch. And the other thing is, you can make a turning circle accordingly with the help of manual update, geo shapes, an arc or a circle. You manually create it. Whenever you drop anchor, click on shape, OK. You'll see a circle. You can select the radius, whatever you like. Like I have selected 500. Done. Now you can see the radius is there, the circle is here. I can edit this, change the position if I want. Radius, if I want to increase, I can increase it. In the attributes, you have option for line weight. You can put thin line. As you can see, the circle will change as I change the line weight. Thin, regular, heavy, thick, fill opacity, I put it transparent so that we know that this is specifically we are using it for anchorage purposes, and I put it and it is done. But as soon as your vessel will go out, it will not give you an alarm, because this ACDIS doesn't have a feature of turning circle of swinging circle. I mean swinging circle, there is no feature on this. Like we have done training on the safe bridge, in that it shows a swinging circle, but in this it is totally different than the safe bridge which we have done. As safe bridge training also states that we can run a playback mode in this ACDIS, but in this ACDIS there is no playback mode as such. As you can see here, there is only ACDIS option is coming. When you have when you will be learning in safe bridge mode, here there will be an option for radar overlay. You can see options for radar overlay, and same, we don't have a radar overlay in this ACDIS. So there is no radar overlay, there is no swinging circle. एंड सेम देर इज नो प्ले प्लेबैक मोड, यू कैन नॉट प्ले बैक एनीथिंग. चार्ट क्वेरी, चार्ट क्वेरी इज एन ऑप्शन, यू कैन क्लिक एनी वेयर. लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू सी दिस ऑब्जेक्ट, वॉट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट, आई जस्ट राइट क्लिक ऑन द दिस चार्ट क्वेरी, इट विल शो यू वॉट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट. लाइट, द डिटेल्स ऑफ द लाइट विल बी हियर, कोस्ट लाइन विल शो यू, लैंडमार्क विल शो यू, क्यूरोकुशिमा लाइट, द साउंडिंग अराउंड एरिया इट विल शो यू, स्पॉट साउंडिंग्स, डेप्थ कॉन्टूर्स, लैंड एलिवेशन एंड वेरियस थिंग्स. चार्ट डेंजर्स, चार्ट डेंजर्स इज द लुक अहेड टाइम, सॉरी द चार्ट डेंजर्स वॉट एवर अलार्म्स विल कम, इफ देर आर डेंजर्स और इट इज अ कॉशन अलार्म, इट विल शो हियर. लाइक आई हैव अ वार्निंग प्रेजेंट हियर, इफ आई क्लिक ट्रू पास पोजिशन डॉट 30 मिनट कस्टम चार्ट डिस्प्ले, सो आई विल चेंज द कस्टम अलार्म तो रह गई. ओके, देन चार्ट वन सिंबल डायग्राम, चार्ट वन सिंबल लाइब्रेरी कलर डायग्राम, यू कैन सी ऑल दिस. चार्ट वन कैटलॉग एग्जिस्ट सिंबल्स ए एंड बी, पार्ट टू नेचुरल मैन मेड, ऑल द सिंबल्स विल बी विजिबल हियर. So this is the feature of this menu. Here you have north up and course up. You can put it on course up, you can put it on north up. This is for true motion. You can select, basically you can reset the limit as other like this. You can just drag down and put your position where you want to be, or you can just keep it in center of the axis, or you can keep at the extreme end of the axis. In this you have to right click here, set TM limit, and you have to put anywhere. Like if I put double click here, the position will shift here. Same if I want my position into the center, I have to set the limit for here. So when it is here, you can see there is a box coming around. I'll try to show you the box if it is possible. You can see a box around this. So this is the limit my vessel will be, as I will make max. So max, the vessel will shift a little bit aft. Center, the max, the vessel will come to the center of the box. Another feature which is not there is, like I was telling you, you guys can drag and just shift your position, and if I want to go back or if I want to go forward, I can see the chart. But no, in this you have to keep it here like this, like this. The arrow, which is, you can see the arrow mark is coming to the edge. If I show you here, the arrow mark is coming here, you have to click like this, or you have an option for pan. You want to put position anywhere, just click pan, or you can just off center your own ship and come back to your original position, so your original position will be back. Other way to do this is, if you are off, you can just click TM limit off, true motion indicator limit off, it will come back to the original position. Okay, from here you can set the look ahead distance, alarms on caution, show safety region, local display will display all this, show safety region, highlight safety contour and highlight nav hazards, whatever the cautions, alarm will be there, the alarm will come. This is the MOB feature. MOB feature is, as soon as you click select, as you can see the MOB mark is here. Okay, select a position on the chart. So select here, the MOB mark comes here. Wherever, if there is an man overboard event, and if you want to plot a position on your ECDIS, you just have to simply select on this man overboard and it will directly select the position where you have selected the MOB. If you want to cancel the MOB event, just click on cancel MOB and yes. But in case you have to start, just click here. As soon as you put, the MOB will put the marker position where you have started the MOB. This is the basic feature of this bar. Now, as you see, as I put my cursor down below, this bar comes. As you can see, as I put my cursor down, the taskbar here appears. It will show you the GPS position lat long. If you click on position, it will give you the position. It will give you a position. From the echo sounder, it will give you the depth also. But this will only show until, as my echo sounder shows, until 800 meters only. So it will show until 800 meters. After that, the readings won't come. It will be any reading which was the last one. It will show that the time, as I have selected local cursor option. From cursor you can see, if I want to see this bearing and position of this, so this is the bearing. This is I'm 65 miles off the lighthouse, 68 degrees. And it will also show you the time to reach that lighthouse. It will be 4 hours and 29 minutes. But the position is showing of the cursor where I have kept. You can see the ring. Now this is a 4 nautical mile ring and ring off. This feature we have seen mostly in radars. This is a feature. Generally it is easy because your first ring is 4 nautical mile. You can see on the cursor it is showing you first ring is 4 nautical mile. So it is easy that you can make out any vessel, how far it is, by just looking at the rings. Approximation you can get that this vessel is between 16 to 24 miles, and if I click here it will show you. ERBL. You all must be knowing the ERBL function. In this we have offset origin, center, carry origin. So you put it on center, you can see the ERBL. You can see this also. Now you see this drop EBL VRM endpoint. We can use this ERBL function as a running fix. Just click here, drop ERBL. So once you have dropped, this position is steady, but the ship position will change. Let me show you. As you see, I cannot change this bearing now because I have fixed the endpoint. Endpoint is fixed and the origin point is now moving. So my vessel will keep on moving and it will keep on giving me the exact distance and the bearing to the lighthouse all the time until I deselect this function. Just drop center. This I was telling you, when you set a true relative motion, true motion, if you press center, if you press max, it will shift to the aft. If you press center, it will stay on the center. if I set my limits to the extreme end because I want to see the full range of the chart, I'll put max, it will go to the aft. Okay, so here's the feature of split screen, secondary display button, and this, it will show you a single chart. This will show you a single chart, and this will show you a display which can be a vertically two displays or horizontally two displays or a picture in pin picture. So when you split screen vertical, your screen will be something like this. Center, max, you can see here, but you can also see here, you can see a closure version and you can see a full chart here. When you split your screen in horizontally, the same will come, but it will be in a horizontal view. And if you put in picture, you still have the full like this, but you have an additional showing here, picture in picture of your like this. This will be a secondary. You want to go back to your initial, just click show a single chart, you will be back to where you were. If you want to go to some position, like if I am making if I have received a NavTex warning and I want to check, is it in my position, is it in my leg, I'll just press go to, I'll put the lat long which I desire to go, and it will take me to a lat long where I am supposed to go. So from there I can check, is it in my route, does that NavTex warning is applicable for me or not, and I can mark that accordingly. Or this function can be used for various things. For if you want to check a pilot position, you can just put a go to pilot position. You can take the position from ALRS and put it here, and then you can go directly and check, is there a pilot point or not. Here, now bearing to wheel over, never use this feature. Docking. This generally we use when the vessel is going alongside. It will show you the speed of your athwart ship, or how fast your bow is turning, how fast your stern is swinging. It will give you the speed of it. It will give you the rate of turn indicator, how fast you are swinging. In this same, steering mode and route info will come together. No, not for us. We don't have bow thrusters. Relative wind. This function, as you must have seen in Safe Bridge, when you're using the Safe Bridge training program, this function works. It will show you the relative wind, but here in actual it will not show you. It is not it is not a part of the ECDIS here. So connection is not made for the relative wind, so it will not show it here. Same goes for true wind. No connection is made with the anemometer, so it will not show you here. Eye help is something that if you click on a chart, this display will come. When the system has successfully started up, blah blah blah, too many things will be written here. You can launch an explorer, it will show you the basic part of the ECDIS operation on this ECDIS. How to use, which part to use, where to use, it will show you everything, overview of the ECDIS. Now coming on to the last is show menu. This menu, help is an option, same which you can get from iHelp. System, in system you have profiles, options, diagnostic. In diagnostic, if you want to see a data log of past positions and something, you can just go on the data log, view data log. You can see here all the UTC timings are there, accordingly you can check your position. If you have made an LOP fix, So the fix will be here. It will show you here. So the last fix made was on 28th September. It is easy to see here. Composite fix LOP1. Man overboard events will come here, as we had just marked 2 times man overboard, so events will be recorded here. But in the CCRS you can file the log file, which is we are using. Time is total workstation hours, total run, total this Agdis has run for 36,100 hours. Sensor status is showing green, only it is showing yellow for echo sounder, because as I told you the depth is more than 3000 here, so it is showing yellow. Once the depth is in limit, it will show again green. Current master Agdis 2. Here it will show you which is the master Agdis or the slave Agdis. So the master Agdis on my system is Agdis 2. This is the Agdis 1. Buzzer I can test. You can see buzzer test was done. Connection status should show green for both the Agdis. If there is any fault, it would show yellow or red. In nav tools you have various options: parallel index line, clearing lines, line of position, own chip history, parallel cursor, distance line, display settings, man overboard. So man overboard is the same thing which I have showed you earlier. From here, this is the shortcut for man overboard. Parallel indexing line, you can select and set the PI lines if you want, like this lines which are made here, as you can see. Clearing lines are in a passage where it is required. So I will show you in further videos if I have made any clearing lines, I will show you there. LOP. So LOP is in this Agdis, is you have your cursor, like I'll mark a LOP fix for you. Like this is the lighthouse I'm taking. So the lighthouse bearing and distance is 089 and 49 miles. So I'll just right click here, add a line of position. So the position will come automatically, 89 and 45 or 49, whatever was the distance. Just click add LOP. Once you add an LOP, this mark will come. You can see the LOP mark. I'll zoom in for you. You can see the LOP mark is here. You have to accept the fix. Once you accept the fix, it is accepted. Then you have to clear it out, and then only you can, until you have not cleared out this fix, you cannot make a next LOP fix. It will not allow you to make an LOP fix. Own chip history, here you have the GPS sensors, position sensor, GPS 1, GPS 2, whichever you like you can select, or don't select. It will, if you have selected primary sensor, so primary is GPS 1 we have selected, it will automatically take that. The history is showing live 24 hours, past position, display events, position details, and the spacing between every position is 1 minute. You can see it here. First position is 9:44, this will be 9:43 9:40. So if you zoom in, you can find out the spacing between position is 1 minute. This is a feature which is given, but it is not very useful. I have never find it useful. You can put a start position and you can put an end position. It will give you the distances between that position and the bearing for that position. but I have never find it useful on this like this. Now display settings. Display settings, you can see all these various settings we have. System I showed you. Now we'll go to alerts. Alerts will show warning, chart permissions, right click for details. So it is showing why the warning is there. Chart subscription services expired, contact your agent or distributor, blah 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 blah, too many things. Long mute length, the mute length setting is longer than recommended, because it is, this warning is showing because I have muted this. Depth below transducer data from EcoSounder is currently unavailable. As I showed you, EcoSounder status was showing yellow. So this is all because of that. Now you go to prompts. Prompts will show you whatever active alarms and prompts we have. Now we are on custom chart display and true post position dots are 32 minutes. So it is just showing you active prompts. Mute setting. Mute length unlimited, you can deselect and you can put a mute length of whatever time you want, but maximum time you can put is anything. Maximum time you can put is 999 minutes. Sensors, heading sensor, log sensor, course over ground, speed over ground, position, depth below keel, this is from the EcoSounder, set and drift, rate of turn, date and time, wind. Now we go to charts. Charts, these all settings I had showed you previously from here. So either you select charts from here or you select charts from here. Brilliance, you can select day night mode, day bright, day black, dusk and night. Now if you want to change the time, there are two ways to change the time. One, you go from system, time management, and you select east or west and how many hours of GMT, and it will show you here. So this is the UTC time, this is the local time. So I have selected local time for my system. If I select UTC, it will show you UTC. Shortcut for this is just click here and change from here. Same goes for brightness and all, you can click here, can change here. Now the basic thing which we use mostly is how to plot a passage, how to plot some manual corrections, how to make layers. These are the basic steps that I will share you with guys in my next video. Thank you.